What a beautiful afternoon and what a great day. And I can already tell there's excitement in the room. You ran down that aisle like nobody's business. So this is good. We are gathered together today, you know, very close, intimate friends and family to witness the matrimony of Rick and Kristi. And it's not just them, but it's also families that are being blended together. And we are so thankful for that today. Want to open up, by the way, Josh, you can smile. There you go. You're making me nervous, son. I want to share with you a verse that is very special to both Rick and Kristi. And what a beautiful depiction of God's love. And as we have this family here together, Ecclesiastes 4, 9 through 12 says, two people are better off than one, for they can help each other succeed. If one person falls, the other can reach out and help. But someone who falls alone is in real trouble. Likewise, two people lying close together can keep each other warm. But how can one be warm alone? A person standing alone can be attacked and defeated, but two can stand back to back and conquer. Three are even better, for a triple braided cord is not easily broken. And it's so wonderful that when two people come together, and the Lord is part of that triple braided cord, there is real power, there is real strength, there is real unity. Who today gives this woman to be married to this man?
I do.
Give your mom a kiss. There you go. There you go. Stand with her for a moment. Would you pray with me today? Father God, we just thank you today for this beautiful family that is joining together today in the sight of you and in the sight of the witnesses of these people today. And God, we just pray your greatest blessing and your greatest prosperity and wisdom and guidance upon this family. In Jesus' name, amen. Amen. Now, I'm sure that there are some people that are wondering why. Would you step up just a little bit? People wondering why I'm standing here and you're standing there. The great part about it is, my nerves are now 100%. They're not looking at me anymore, except for the bald spot in the back of my head. But they are looking at you, because I figure these people are here to see you, and if anybody's watching online, they don't care about me. They may not even like me. But this today is about what you two have committed to together. And I just wanted to share this verse that we were talking about the other night. And I want to share that verse with you and then just share some thoughts with you. It says in Joshua 24, verses 14 and 15, so fear the Lord and serve him wholeheartedly. Put away forever the idols your ancestors worshiped when they lived beyond the Euphrates River and in Egypt. Serve the Lord alone. But if you refuse to serve the Lord, then choose whom you will serve. Would you prefer the gods your ancestors served beyond the Euphrates? Or will it be the gods of the Amorites in the land you now live? And here's the part. But as for me and my family, we will serve the Lord. It's a very special verse to you. It's a very special verse to you. It's a very special verse to me. It is a verse of great resolution, a resolve that says this is how it's going to be. Choose to go that way, then go that way. If you choose to go that way, go that way. But as for me and my family, we will choose to serve the Lord. There are four things, and Rick, you can smile because guess what? They all have the same letter, but I promise it won't be long. But there are four things that I look in this that I just want to challenge you with. This is a verse that you like and a verse that you believe that you're standing on. It is a verse that I believe that God speaks some truths. How fitting it is today. Number one is direction. It says, as for me and my family. But as for me and my family. See, God has called you to be the leader of your household, the leader of your family, and together you two are the leaders of your family. But as for me and my family, there is a direction that we are going. There is a leadership. As a lion and a golden retriever together, and nobody knows what that means, there is a leadership, and there is something that you are going after that you see and you know that is what you want, and you're going to get it. There's a direction. But as for me and my family, what other people do is their business. But as for me and my family, there is a direction here. There is a resolution here. There is leadership here. We're not leaving this to chance. We're not leaving this to random. We are standing upon a strategy built on the solid rock of Jesus Christ as for me and my family. There's that decision. So we have that direction. There's leadership. We know we're going somewhere, where we're going. There's a decision that we are making. But as for me and my family, we will. We will. We're making a choice. This is something that we do. I hope that one day, I hope that I plan on and believe that my children are going to serve the Lord all of their life. But as for right now, I can't make them choose to follow Jesus, but they go to church. It's something that we do together as a family. There's a lot of choices they get to have, but choosing to brush their teeth is not one of them. Choosing to change their undergarments is not one of them. There is a choice that is being made, a direction and a decision. This is how it's going to be. As for me and my family, we will. And I encourage you and challenge you with that as you stand on the solid rock of Christ. That there is that direction. This is where we're going. And the decision. We are not letting anything stand in the way of this. This is the choice that we have made. Because if you don't make your choices, situations and circumstances will make those choices for you. Emotions will make those choices for you. Laziness will make those. Anger will make those choices. But no, we have already made our direction. We're following the Lord. And we've already made our decision. We will. We will. And by the way, there's going to be some moments, as everybody behind me knows, there are moments where our emotions will try to betray us. And there will be moments where we're overwhelmed with all kinds of different things. That's where you need to remember this decision. I will. I will. And when you begin to get a hold of I will, the statement changes also. We are. I am. We are. And that is a beautiful thing. So there's direction, decision, and determination. But as for me and my family, we will serve. We will serve. We're going to do this. There's going to be things that come up. So you say, well, that sounds a lot like decision. Yes, but have you ever made a decision and then not followed through with it? You made a decision based on what you knew was right, but you didn't follow through. See, that determination says this is what we are going to do. Because I know that Philippians 4:13 says, I can do all things through Christ who strengthens me. When the enemy comes in like a flood, so shall the Spirit of the Lord lift up a standard against him. Greater is he that is in me than he that is in the world. The greater one lives on the inside of me. I am determined that we can do this. So we have our direction. Make our decision. And we are determined. And then it brings us to this. There's direction, decision, determination, and dedication. So what do you mean? That sounds like the rest of it. But as for me and my family, we will serve the Lord. He is the one. See, as much as we like to make marriage about all you're dedicating one to another, yes, that's all well and good. But if there's not a dedication to the Lord first, then a dedication to one another, maybe 50-50. But when we dedicate ourselves to the Lord and you, Kristi, are solely looking to Him and you, Rick, are solely looking to Him, guess what happens? When you are looking this way and you are looking this way, you can't help but to meet. But if you're just focusing on each other, you know what also is going to happen at times? Butting heads. But if you're focusing on Jesus, you're focusing on Jesus. But as for me and my family, we are dedicated to worshiping Him. We are dedicated to praying. We are dedicated to serving Him. We are dedicated to following Him. We're dedicated to leading others to Him. We are dedicated to Him first. We will worship. We will pray. We will exalt. We will be humble. We will make mistakes and we will learn. We will be corrected, but we know that it's because He loves us. That's for me and my family. Listen, our culture goes the way it goes. That's for me and my family. But as for me and my family, we are directionally going towards Him. We have made a decision. We are determined. We are dedicated to Him. But as for me and my family, we will serve the Lord. Now, what is very neat as we have been talking together is that you have some statements that you would like to share. Some vows that you have written. And so I'm going to give you the microphone. Rick, you're going to do that, and you can hand the microphone to her, and we will continue.
Kristi, before you, your family, my family, our children, our church family, and the Lord Himself, I promise to honor your name, to love you unconditionally as Christ loved the church. I promise to seek first the kingdom of God, believing in faith that he will meet our every spiritual, physical, emotional, and relational need for our family. I promise to recognize you and our family as my second love that will only be exceeded by my love for Jesus Christ and the gospel message. Fishing may be a close third. I promise to make you laugh often, taking special care that none of my jokes are ever at your expense. I promise to encourage you by reminding you constantly who you are in Jesus Christ. I promise to treat you with patience, kindness, and gentleness, because that's how my King treats me. I promise to refrain from disrespectful, unwholesome talk that invites bitterness that God has been so faithful to graciously remove from our past. I promise to pay close attention to any and all concerns that you have, great or small, to be a quiet listener. I promise to challenge you and spur you on towards the goal of complete trust and surrender in our Lord Jesus Christ. I promise to uphold with great care the position of the spiritual leader of our household given to me by God. I promise to take responsibility for the final say in all the tough decisions that must be made that will affect our family. I promise to make those decisions only after I've sought counsel from wise Christians who have gone successfully before me, and from the Lord himself through humble prayer and with a spirit of sensitivity to his leading. When I fail to keep any of these promises, I promise to repent and ask for forgiveness from my Lord and from those who I've hurt. I promise to make forgiveness a priority and a commonplace in our home, to be an example for our children when it is determined by me. And because you believe, as I believe, in the very vows that we recite before God, I promise that as God has never given up on me, I will never give up on you or our children. Whether weak or needy, or strong and having plenty, we will praise him. As for me and my household, we will serve the Lord. Let us serve the Lord.
Rick, as we stand here before God and before our family and friends, I want to recognize God's authority over my life. He has chosen me to be his own, and I celebrate the fact that he is my first love. With that being said, I promise to keep Christ as my center, to love him first, but to always keep you a close second. I promise to love, honor, respect, cherish, and submit to you as my spiritual leader. I know that with these new joys God has given me, I face new responsibilities that I will not be able to fulfill in my own strength. But I can say with complete confidence, with Christ as the center of our lives, the center of our relationship, in the center of our home, through his strength, his grace, and power, I'm excited to walk this journey with you. I promise to do my best to faithfully fulfill my place as your helpmate, to be obedient to God's purpose for me in your life, in our lives together, to uphold you in prayer, to encourage you, and submit my heart to you, to always be by your side through all circumstances, through every valley, and on every mountaintop. I praise God for you, for your friendship, and for your love.
Rick and Kristi, I remind you that marriage is a precious gift. It's a lifelong dedication to love and a daily challenge to love one another more fully and more freely. Now, with this understanding, do you, Rick, promise to take Kristi as your beloved wife? You promise to be a tender, faithful husband and to love her as Christ loves the church. Do you promise to love her and cherish her in sickness and in health, for richer, for poorer, for better, for worse, and keep yourself only under her for as long as you both shall live? Now, Kristi, with this understanding, do you promise to take Rick as your beloved husband? Do you promise to be a tender and faithful wife and honor him as the church honors Christ? Do You promise to love and cherish him in sickness and in health, for richer, for poorer, for better, for worse, and keep yourself only unto him for as long as you both shall live. Rick and Kristi, you have chosen rings as the outward symbol of your commitment to each other. You have those rings? Okay. Getting good at those words. From the earliest times, rings have been a symbol of wedded love, an unbroken and never-ending circle that symbolizes a commitment to a love that is also never-ending. And that is a love that is something that is an overflow of the love that Christ has for us. When you think of the Trinity of God, there is no beginning, there is no end. It just keeps on going. 1 John 4, 7 and 8 teaches us that, for God is love. And so God is love, and he is unending. That which he is also unending. Love is unending. And so the love that you have today is not based on a cultural understanding of an affection or feeling, but it is based on who God is, for God is love. So, Rick, take Kristi's hand, and I want you to place the ring on her finger, and I want you to say to her these words. From this day on, I commit myself to you.
I commit myself to you.
And this ring is a symbol.
And this ring is a symbol.
Of my covenant to you.
Of my covenant to you.
Now, Kristi, take Rick's hand, place the ring on his finger. And I want you to repeat these words and say these to him. From this day on.
From this day on.
I commit myself to you.
I commit myself to you.
And this ring is a symbol. Of my covenant to you. Let these rings serve as locks binding you, not as locks binding you together, but as keys unlocking the secrets of your heart for each other to know, and thus bringing you closer and closer together. As you and I have talked, one of the things that you have said that you would like to do, and what we're going to do now, I'm excited for God and these friends is that your first act as a husband and wife is to take your communion.
He must have a plan.
some pretty hefty commitments in the sight of God. I know that He will bless you, and He will be the strength that enables you and empowers you to put one foot in front of the other as you are hand in hand together with your eyes fixed on Him, who is the author and the perfecter of your faith and your family. So Richard Henderson and Kristi Turner, by the authority committed to me as a minister of the gospel of Jesus Christ, in accordance to the ordinance of God and the laws of the Commonwealth of Pennsylvania, I now pronounce you husband and wife in the name of the Father, the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Amen. Whom God hath joined together, let no man separate. What are you looking at me for? You can kiss the bride. Ladies and gentlemen, it is my privilege and pleasure to introduce to you for the first time, and I know you've, how many times, I wonder, have you already written this name out? I don't know. Mr. and Mrs. Richard and Kristi Henderson.